Hello, welcome to my presentation about the integration of the patent information professional position and patent information in a company. My name is Erik de Kok. I hope that this information will be valuable to you. So I think all of you as a patent attorney, you know what a patent information professional is, but just to share my views about what I think this patent information professional is doing, I have some points here written down. I think in general, what a patent information professional does is responding to questions, all sorts of questions related to patentability, infringement, landscaping, and oppositions. But very often it's a one-way street. So even you as a patent attorney could be going to a patent information professional saying, oh, could you give me that information? But is that necessarily the information that you need? And you know, when it's a one-way street, I think it's better to have some conversation about it. And I think it's better to have a conversation about what's going on. So what could this person do in general? I think it could move on to a very more service-oriented role. And I have some bullet points written down on this slide that could be of value for that. An active role in R&D processes to provide services, not just answers, not the answer that you may be getting, but maybe a little bit more. Integration with other departments and not just R&D, because there's a lot more information available in a company that you might think of. An active role in the filing process as such, and I think as a patent attorney, that is a core process actually. Risk evaluation, when finally something comes to market, and very personal for me as well, a hand in glove with a patent attorney. Now, let's first move to the active role in the R&D processes. I found over the years, there's a lot of information that you know people don't have. They want to have it, but they don't know where to find it. They have no clue where to go to. This is, I think, an excellent role for the patent information professional to fulfill. The patent information professional knows where to find the information and he also knows how to handle it. Moreover, actually, if an R&D project starts in the beginning, in the early idea generation, building up the knowledge is very vital. It's a vital part of the process when you start and you gather the information together so the patent information professional can provide you with that information. So you are an R&D person and you want to start a project, but you don't know where to start. Is there already information available? Is something blocked maybe? Or is there anything that is out in the open? I think the patent information professional could be encouraged a little bit more than it's done nowadays to go to R&D and to have the discussion with the R&D people to make sure that this information is going back and forth. And I think the cooperation with R&D is very important, of course. And in this way, discussing with the PIP, what direction we're going, where do you wish to go? Are there maybe parts blocked or maybe some parts are available to you? Could you maybe build on what is going on, what is already there? That's all very valuable information. And not only just in the idea generation, but also further on when you have a development process and you develop over time, there's always this information that could be gathered from the patent information professional. So I think in general, to narrow down the direction to be taken from a process that is starting, the patent information professional can play a very vital and proactive role in this idea generation process. And to provide a service, not just answers. I think it's very important to go beyond the question because very often in practice, and I have that in my own practice as well, people just come to you and say, I want an answer to this question and preferably by tomorrow. Well, that's all very nice, but it's very handy for me as well to have some information. What is it about? What kind of landscape are you painting around it? Why do you need it? If you have that information, you can provide a better answer. I call that service, not just giving the answer to the question, but go beyond the question. What is there? What is needed? What does the client need? Because very often, as a client, and even as an attorney at times, you don't even know what you really question is. You need to go beyond what is there and to have more information than you will get from just asking the question. So I think it's important to find out the answer together, to explain, to ask, go back and forth, and then you will find what is needed to move forward. Oh, something went wrong here. Then integration with other departments, especially on the commercial side of things like marketing, sales, product management, that kind of departments. Finding the right names, the information that is there, seeing what direction information is there from competitors, your own direction. They all know that. That information, and we live in an information society actually, is not always used, not always by the patent information professional, but also the patent information is not always used by the commercial departments. And I think that information could be very valuable to a company. So making that connection is important too. And of course, the natural ally, the legal department, related to maybe NDAs, the IP clauses, or oppositions, legal court cases, that is also very important to have the establishment of patent information. So people know back and forth what is happening in the field. And in my case, if you work with external patent attorneys, it's also vital to use external patent attorneys and that they know what kind of information they need to do proper draft, opposition, or office actions. Those kind of information is very valuable to have the connection between the patent information professional and the external attorneys. The active role in the filing process. Now, I think that this is a core process for every patent attorney. And filing, when you have this information, like I said in the beginning, an R&D process, in the beginning as an idea generation, maybe further on moving, development. If you have an idea and you know what is there, what kind of information you could use, it's very valuable that these connections are made, that the patent information professional knows what kind of projects are taking place, and that the R&D person actually knows what kind of information could be delivered and what information is there. So not only talking about being blocked, but also having the information of what could be built on, what is there, what is not there, what kind of directions could we take. Now, if this is an active engagement with the inventor, the patent information professional can provide the information to the inventor, have a thorough understanding of the patent or of the invention and what is needed to move forward. And I would like to see that as a triangle in that sense, the inventor, the patent information professional and the patent attorney all working together to provide the right kind of information, you know, in my case, to the external patent attorney. So that external patent attorney can start to draft with the right kind of information. And I think that's a vital process. And if I think back about my own time, when I was drafting myself, I always used the information that was already there and trying to assess that and analyze it while even drafting. Now, if you do that in a proper manner, have all the information together, what it comes down to is everything is there. So you have actually lowered down the risk and lowering the amount of office actions that are needed to move forward and get a grant from the patent office, saving yourself some time, but also saving time on the other side. And especially when the external attorney is involved, there's a lot of money that could be saved there as well. Now, if you think about risk evaluation searches, usually those are the most difficult ones because a product comes to market or there's a method to be sold. Anyway, there's this time to market, and then of course it's a bit of a stressful situation. Are we there yet or not? If you think about being involved in the early idea generation, moving on in the R&D process, and then maybe filing a patent application on it, then risk evaluation searches are not that difficult in that sense, because the information is already there. R&D has got the information. Maybe you've got some information from other departments as well, but the patent information professional has all the information put together. So when the risk evaluation needs to be done, we know the design freedom area. There is this knowledge of the products that are already there. What is the knowledge of the competitors and the knowledge of the state of the art? So all the information is right there, complete, and to be used for evaluation. Then one important thing, especially, you know, considering myself, if I look at it, the hand in glove with the patent attorney. I started out as a patent searcher and changed into a patent attorney role, but actually have never forgotten how that patent information and searching works, and still doing that on a daily basis, actually. For me, patent attorney and patent information professional, we are doing one job, which is providing protection for our clients. It could be two people, of course, but in the end, we're performing one job. I think there's a role for this as well. The working together with the patent attorney, like the assistants in all patent matters that are there, you know, knowing what is there, advising the attorney, but also the other way around, the attorney advising the patent information professional, because there are lots of things going back and forth where you need some information, and asking for feedback and information. What's going on? What kind of search did you do? You know, what kind of keywords did you use? I think these things are all very valuable, also for a patent attorney, to have that kind of information readily available. And, you know, it helps me at least to get into a topic and to know the terminology and using when drafting. In this way, I think you move slowly to a client-oriented service department. And that is much more than just ticking the box, having the search done, and get on with it. I think I've come to the conclusion of my talk today. What is important for me, for patent information and the patent information professional, increasing the visibility of this position and, of course, of patent information. Like I said, we live in an information society. There's a lot of information there, but it's not always used in good manner. If the patent information professional is more integrated and more visible in the company, then it will lead to more engagement. It will lead to better understanding and also a better cooperation between all the departments. And the end result, you know, is a better protection for your client. And I think that's actually the core of what we do. So with this, I come to the end of my presentation. I would like to thank you for your attention. If there are any questions, please let me know after the presentation. And I would like to thank the EPO, Yolanda Sanchez Garcia, for having the opportunity to talk to you today in the patent attorney track, and also to my colleague Anne Gandini-Trunli for implementing this in the company at this point in time. So I would like to thank you for your attention. I'll be happy to take any questions today. And have a good day. Thank you.